Good morning, YouTube. So I've got to do a little bit of work on my attic fans here. Unscrew them here. Apparently some bees or yellow jackets or something built a nest up in the vent here. I've got my garbage can here to catch all the stuff. I think this fell down in here. Yep, there we go. Get that cleared out. So that was blocking my airflow a little bit. This is a 4x9 inch oval duct. I think these were installed when the house was built, and there used to be a flue for an in-wall gas heater that was here. At some point before I purchased it, these two heaters were removed and a central forced air heater was installed. So whoever installed the forced air heater removed the in-wall heaters, and they just left these two holes in the roof. So back in 2013, I decided to come up here and take a look at the attic. I had never really been up here much at all. It was very uncomfortable because it would get well over 140 Fahrenheit up here in the summer. Anyway, so I was up here. I was working on some insulation projects up here and putting down some plywood so I could get over and access things. And I was looking at these openings here, and it's like, you know what? Those are about the same size as a 120 millimeter case fan, a piece of 1x8 lumber. And I marked out a hole and cut a kind of a tapered hole here. So it's about 5 inches wide here. And then inside it's about 4 inches wide, and I set the jigsaw blade at an angle, so I basically cut out a hole to match the taper there, and that lets these fans blow air straight up out of those holes. So yeah, this makes a really nice ducted output for these fans. And let me get this one back in place here. I usually come up every couple of years and use a toothbrush to clean off the blades, but there's no loose dust on there, so I think that's good. I don't know how you pronounce that, if it's Silence or Silenex. So these are their 120 millimeter case fans. They're rated at 74 cubic feet per minute, free airflow. So these fans were installed in July 2013. It's now July 2019. They've been running for 6 years. They're powered by solar power, 12 volt DC. So the house has a metal tile roof. And the reason I installed these fans was because they fit these holes that exist in the roof. So when I was thinking about ventilating the attic, I initially looked at some of those Whirlybird wind-powered vents. Those need about a 14-inch diameter cutout in the roof, and with that tile roof, it's not easy to do that. You probably have to hire a competent roofer that's got experience working with tile roofs to cut the hole, install the fan, and then seal it up so it doesn't leak. That would probably cost about $500 to do that. And then I also looked at some of those solar attic fans, which mount up on the roof. They have a solar panel on top, a fan in the middle, and then the opening in the roof, and those need about a 13 inch diameter cutout. I had 9 inches here, not 13. And the other problem with those solar fans, they only run when the sun is shining. They don't have any batteries to them. This fan will run all night if it's hot up here. So these fans, they really do work. I'll turn the thermostat down a little bit, get them to kick on here. Oh, there they go. I just bumped the thermostat and it turned on. So I was informed by a knowledgeable viewer that these kind of fans don't move any air. They are a total joke, and they don't move air at all. That must be some sort of anti-gravity vortex thing going on there. I don't know how that paper is being held up there, but that looks like it's working there. And here's my airflow meter. This is a Mannix DCFM-8906. Let's take a air measurement here. Okay, there we go. We've got 356 feet per minute airflow. So I've programmed in the size of the duct there. Okay, so that's the airflow we get, 89 cubic feet per minute. And there's this pair of fans. There's another pair of fans about 12 feet that way. And then on both gable vents, there's another pair of fans on each gable vent. So that would be a total of 360 cubic feet per minute airflow. And the attic is about 1,200 square feet. And the average height is about 2 feet. It's about 4 foot peak in the middle and then goes down to zero at each side. So you've got about 2,400 cubic feet of air up here. 360 CFM of ventilation gives 9 air changes per hour, which is maybe a little short. I've seen recommendations of about 12 ACH for an attic. There's a whole section of the attic where there's no ventilation at all. It's off to the side. So in the main attic here, we've probably got about 12 ACH because about a quarter of the attic is off to the side, and I would like to add some ventilation over there. I'll probably add a gable vent because that part of the house, there's like no ventilation at all. This may not be ideal, but this is what I have to work with. And right here, this is the thermostat. It's an adjustable temperature thermostat with fire stat. So this has both the thermostat that you can adjust the on-off temperature, and then it also has a low melting point fusible link that will melt and open if there's a fire up here that gets above its temperature, and that will shut off the fans in case there's a fire. This is the sort of thermostat you use to control attic fans. Just I happen to be using it on 12 volt DC. So I showed you in the earlier video how I added a snubber network to the contacts in here to help with arcing because it's switching DC voltage instead of AC voltage. Now these 8 fans that I have in here only draw a little over 1 amp. I think it's 1.1 amps at 13.8 volts. So they're really not a high power draw. So I could have one large fan that moved 360 CFM, or I could have 8 smaller fans that move about 45 each. Now some people will of course say that's stupid, idiotic, you shouldn't do that. Well, here's my whole house fan. This is a commercially produced whole house fan from Airscape Fans in Oregon. And instead of one big fan, they use 4 smaller fans, 2 that blow this way, 2 that blow that way. On really hot days, I use this to cool off the attic. So far this year, it's middle of July. I've used this, I think, 5 days out of the year. The rest of the year, the 12-volt fans do the job. Now, these are brushless motors. The fans for the attic vents are DC brushless motors. They just happen to be smaller than these. Here's 4. I've got 8 of the little fans. And let's go take a look at one of the other setups here. So here's one of the other fan pairs over here. This one I had also a bit of debris in there that was blocking the one fan. So let me screw it back in place here. And let's get an airflow reading over here. Yes, there we go. 381 feet per minute. Let me get around here where I can hold this thing so we can see the display. 381. And that's 95 CFM. I think we're getting close to 100 CFM per pair of fans, which is 50 CFM each, and they're rated at 74, so about two-thirds of what they're rated at. Yeah, those are working just fine. So again, this was an existing hole in the roof that I took advantage of, and there's really no bigger fan that I could have put in there because it's 4 inches wide and then 9 inches across on the duct, and that's how big it is. I can't put a bigger fan in there because it really wouldn't work. And these are quite silent. You'd hardly hear them. When the attic door is closed, you don't hear them at all. And you can see down here is one of the other fan pairs in the gable vent. And then up here, this is my LED light strip. There's three of these strip lights, 5 meters each, up here. These have been running in the attic, hot summer temperatures up here, so not a single LED chip has burnt out. And the reason I like these is because they're safe to touch, they're cool, you can't get a shock on them. The fans run off of solar power. It's all solar powered up here. I'll put a link to the video where I did some temperature testing up here. So I'll put a link to that video up in the upper right corner, and you can check that out. The real advantage of these fans, they're not super powerful, I will admit. These are not like your Hollywood movie set fans that blow your hair back, you know, like you see in the movies. These just move a little bit of air, 360, maybe 400 CFM. They are not quite enough to keep up with the temperature. I mean, the temperature in the attic rises slowly during the day. By sundown, the temperature up here will be about 20 degrees higher than the outside temperature. But then, these run off of batteries, and at night, they keep running until the attic cools down to about 70 Fahrenheit. And then, the next morning, once it warms up above about 75, the fans turn on again. Temperature slowly creeps up during the day, and then at night, it drops down, and it's that overnight cooling that resets the temperature up here every day. So the other nice thing with this setup is I can service these fans from inside the attic. I don't have to break out a ladder, climb up on the roof, and expose myself to falling off the roof or damaging a tile or whatever. I can do this from inside the house, even if it's raining or dark. I can come up here at night. I've got light. I can service the fans. That's probably about the third or fourth time I've had to even touch these things in 6 years. So they're very reliable. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, go ahead and post up in the comment section below. Yeah, I'll put some of the other fan videos over here on the left side. You can check those out. And as always, thanks for watching.